SIT and staff and students of SOS HGIC. We also extend a warm welcome to our invited schools, Tema International School, AIDS International Academy, Roman Grade School, Ghana International School, and SOS Chem and Minor School. Is there any other invited school in the house?
Yes. The African Science Academy.
We also extend a warm welcome to you. For this production, we entreat that you turn off all your mobile devices and flash photography, as these may distract or even blind our access to the Queen and the chest of all. When the Queen Mother of Ibusa lies on her deathbed, Nana Yachiche, the headstrong and clever warrior princess, expects to ascend the throne and rule the Ibusa kingdom. But her hopes are dashed when the inheritance is instead given to her younger brother, igniting a passion in her breast that is destined to burn anyone who stands in her way. The Drama Cast group of SOS HGIC warmly invites you to join us as we journey to the royal court of yesteryear to enact Nanaya's tale, immortalized by Eko Kojumawobi. Come with us to fathom the multitudinous passions within the heart of a woman. Thank you.
Who's turn is it? Your turn, my child. See, I have won 6 marbles out of 3 rolls.
That's my son. It's what the elders call serious tactical error.
I don't understand.
You should have waited patiently for me to play all the marbles into these 3 holes, thereby leaving my last 4 holes with 2 marbles each. That way, when it is your turn to play, you would win 12 marbles out of 4 holes. You think it looks so sad? There is still time. Just keep your eyes and your mind open.
It's your turn, mother. Go ahead and play so I can.
Alright, alright. Watch me. 1, 2, 3, 4.
But mother, why did you use the 6 marbles over here to win the 4 marbles over here in my territory?
No, that would have been suicidal for me.
Suicidal? Who would have won you 4 marbles out of 2? Isn't that something worth grabbing?
Not only would I be winning 4 marbles, but I'll be adding extra firepower to your army. And should you decide to attack, my territory will be cleared of all marbles.
I see.
Exactly. As it stands now, you cannot get beyond the interchange I have done over here.
You can't be so strong, mother.
My child, these marbles are 8 in number. And should you decide to use any of them, you will find yourself in the interchange I have done over here.
But mother, how did you know there were 8 marbles over here?
Only fools plant with butter without doing their homework on their enemy strategies. Let's play, my child. It's your turn.
I play this way. I give this one to the 8 I already have.
That gives you 9, my child. Which means you are aiming for the soldiers on station duty beyond the trench over there. Now see what blunder you have committed.
What blunder?
In your attempt to capture these 2 marbles by hook or by hook, you have left your rear totally unguarded, thereby leaving me with 2 clear options. Either to allow you to take 2 of my soldiers and I take 6 of yours out of 1, or I allow you or I recapture my soldiers and allow you time to reconsolidate your position. No! It is a stupid battle strategy to allow your enemy time to remarshal his forces. You must go in for the kill whilst the troops are still in utter disarray. That's it. You are assured of sweet, long-lasting victory. So why are you going in for the 6? And you can have 2 out of 1. That's it. If you still want it. What is the matter, my child? Are you not going to play?
I am hot.
Why is it they're staring at them? Call for reinforcement.
From where?
The police guard.
Mother, how about watching a 3-minute truce?
That's it, a truce. Another cardinal strategy, often employed in warfare and used by point and check the purpose. My son, learn that lesson now. You must never easily give in to a request for a shoe unless you are very, very sure that it offers you the maximum advantage.
Understand that, mother.
Yes, more often than not, it will be a well calculated attempt. It's very tiny in the mind of the opposing army.
Get you, mother.
Well, in warfare, it's often assumed that the army that first used for its use is well only really time to assess its chemical forces.
It's... Oh, I see.
But it's an assumption. Normally, makes the non-shoe sitting arm feel superior, and more often than not, they begin to let their guard down. At that very instant, the seemingly capitulating attack, more fearful than ever, taking his opponent by utter surprise.
Oh, it is so amazing how such wonderful military manoeuvres are even in the game of warrior.
Yes, that is why it is for royals, kings, princes, and princesses. I mean, who like you?
Oh, mother.
Now, let's get back to our immediate task.
No truce?
No! I believe in fighting to the finish. When the enemy is on the ground, you charge! Is it here?
Possibly.
Is it here?
Yes, Your Highness.
Of course. And check who is at the door.
Greetings to you, Your Highness.
Greetings to you. What brings you over here this evening?
Your Highness, a delegation of three has arrived in the palace here with a message for you from your brother, Dastibre Kweku Dria II, ruler of the kingdom.
And what's that message?
Your Highness, the leader of the delegation...
Look here. How many times must I tell you that when you speak to me, you want to go down?
I forgot.
You what?
I almost did.
Next time, I shall hand you over to the executioner to take care of your head. That's me. You do not forget any longer.
Before you, Her Royal Highness, I shall make the ground my sleeping place and wake up only when you ask me to do so.
You better.
Nana, the chief messenger from your brother's palace has refused to help anyone's ears with the message on his tongue, except yours.
I see. When offer them, what has to drink?
Nana, we of your court did not sidestep tradition and custom. Water was the first thing we offered them as a token of our warm welcome. But they refused.
You mean they refuse the water you offer them?
Yes.
But why?
Perhaps they fear the message they have for Nana might get wet.
None of your silly remarks. You must know where you are.
I'm sorry.
Okay. One more of such tasteless remarks, and I will strip you of all your titles. Now.
Nana, they will not bend their knees. They have refused to sit.
Why?
Perhaps. They fear if they sit, the message they have for Nana will... No. I don't know.
the death of
no,
my
No, no! I do not want to jump into the dancing ring before the big drum. Let us wait for the chief lady. Yes, come in.
The chapel smiled at a piece of mahogany and said, we may look alike, but I have been through red hot fire and smoke.
And the piece of mahogany catches me?
No, it replied thus, I have been through nothing, yet I am as black as you.
Every month?
There is a value.
Now let me have a look at your simple ah, I see you are here with this mission. Now what does my brother, the great king, say?
Your Highness, the great king specifically commanded that I speak to you and you alone, and no other person hears.
Ah, but the man over here is my Ochiame.
That I know and understand, but...
Oh. My son, can I have a word with you? Now, Ochiame, are you there?
Nana, I am on my feet.
Yes, of course, the great king Mr. that I am ready for to message.
Nana says that if the message one has to deliver is as huge as a canoe, one does not require a pair of ears as wide as a river to row it on. For her ears, small though they may seem, are capable of hearing anything. So, unfold your tongue. Thank you, Ochiame. Here and let's reach Nana. That Ashu was able to decipher for myself. My colleagues and I are on a peace mission. Our great king, that's the great recruit Dwight II, has asked us to tell your highness that the time has come for him to send to his court, Osuajina, the heir apparent, to be trained in the art of kinship. He says further that old age is catching up with him and his eyes are failing. I am done. Nana, so he said.
So, when must I send my son into this court?
Your Highness, we have orders to bring him along with us on our return journey.
Tomorrow?
Today, Your Highness. On this very day.
But the sun has not even set. The shadows have lingered. Why don't you stay over when night and leave at sunset?
Ochiame, let's reach Your Highness first. We have orders to spend the night at Nkwanta and nowhere else but Nkwanta.
Nana, so he said that their bodies, though weak and weary from travel, must not find respite under Tremfasu's sky.
Right. So, you insist on leaving tonight?
I insist on obeying the orders of Darcy.
Very well. Your message is very well known. I shall call my son and greet him.
Thank you.
Now, Ochiame.
Nana.
Please, take the king's messenger and his colleague to the quarters and ask the woman to take care of him.
Your orders shall be carried out. And I can assure you that they shall not find us wanting in hospitality. This week, Ochiame.
And, Ochiame.
Nana.
Please, get my son, Ous. And bring him to my side.
Yes, Your Highness.
Hey, I am struck. I am honored. Invisible, sharp-pointed spikes of bamboo aimed at my head everywhere I stand. My soul is crushing in on my mind. But time, you swore to be by me. And fate, my efforts, you promised me promise. This is not the time you promised to show up. I need time.
Well, let's sit down. Sit, my child. Sit. Yes. I have to go, Charlie, to fetch you. I remember now. Where do I begin?
Has it got anything to do with the message from my uncle?
Well, yes. And what's more, my child, I believe the time has come for the revealing of the mystery that has puzzled all your young life. I think you have always wished you. Get not excited. Relax. It's a long story.
Never mind. I'm prepared to listen to everything.
It was so many years ago, before I met your father, the man who sowed into my womb the seed that later germinated. When it happened so suddenly, it shook the wise men of the south out of their wits.
And what was that?
A deadly epidemic spread through the length and breadth of the south, causing untold suffering and harm to human life and property.
Property?
Oh, yes. It affected the crops on the farm that year. Famine and its twin attendants, starvation, were the unwelcome guests in every home. It was the period in our people's history to us, the year of plenty.
Ah, here's the annual festival of plenty.
Yes. When the all-knowing, age-old oracle was consulted, it was revealed that an abomination had been committed in the kingdom. And unless the miscreants came forward and confessed his crime and was punished as custom demanded, the fattest lamb in the land.
Just a mere lamb. That's nothing.
That is exactly how the elders of our time reacted. When the persistent appeals for the offenders to come forward and confess had apparently fallen on deaf ears, the gods had no other choice but to strike. And when they did, the axe fell right in the center of our compound house, the palace at Tukwansa. The noise could be heard
was the noise so loud?
Yes. My mother, your grandmother, the queen mother, ruler of the Busa, was the innocent victim of the god's anger.
Oh no.
Oh yes. The strong queen mother, my mother, had fallen sick. She caught a cold in the morning, and by midday she was coughing blood. By nightfall, she was gone.
You mean she was dead?
No. She had crossed over to the other side.
How sad. And was the offender apprehended?
Oh, yes.
Thank God above.
But that is not what I want us to concern ourselves with at the moment. When it became apparent that my mother would not make it to see the sunset of the next day, she called my younger brother and I. When I went into the palace, she was on her deathbed. A few fetish priests of the shrine were dancing around her in seconds. Some divisional chiefs, elders, and king makers of the village were also seated. Are you listening?
Yes, mother.
Now, I want you to hear with your two ears and see with your mind what happened that day at the palace. Now initially I did not want to go, but I heard small voice whispering to me, urging me to go. Get up and go. Get up and go. So I stood up very slowly. I put on my cloth properly, and I made my way to the palace without an escort.
Thank you.
that you see.
I see. No! I don't like what I see.
Just what you see, white one.
I can see dark clouds gathering in the upper stream of the river. And voices. And out. I can see a canoe. Faceless figures going hard towards the other bank of the river. Your Highness, only your son is here.
The words of the elder sister, my daughter, the after one.
She sent a message that she would be coming. Ah, there she is.
Let them stand by me. My children. Darkness is pulling out the truth from the last soil of my life. Dawn shall smile upon my breathless body. I am about to go to the way of our father, to the village of only ancient city and no exit. Water. But I do not wish for it to be said behind me that I was a mother who left her children orphaned and in utter poverty. I ask you to be called here today so I could do you an honor before my journey of this end has been concluded. Bring the stools. Thank you. Bring the sword. To you, I give this. Whoa! I do something. And in due time, you shall be nothing. Ah!
I'll tell you one
must have been made to live here without you. We have had enough of your spirit, man. Who do you think you are?
Yeah. Nana, she's gone.
Sorry, mother. But the truth is, I want
mother.
Now, if it's their mind for themselves, eh? Well, okay.
what's in the poor. And the poor young man, one of his assistants, an angel, sneaked in and breathed into the clay and blew breath. Yes, and when the mama returned and saw what the angel had done, he became angry and gave the angel a sound. But all just aside, the prince, he's very handsome. Yes. And I'm not prepared. For the 6 months he has been with us, I have made it a habit to watch him from the rooftops when he's taking lessons in drum language. And he seems to be having good job at all in the traditional dance. The way the eyes are set in their sockets, with the nose ridge running down into a beautiful open fence of flesh above the upper lip. And see him smile. Oh God. It's as if you had cold water poured on your very body after a serious work in the scorching sun. If you are lucky, you could see the pain right between your veins going through your arteries up to your heart. Only his smile sends me crazy. Forgets that the wedding that causes the smile is always there, and he can smile again and again each time the smile fades out.
Very well. Then I'm going in for his whole body. From the place where he walks. The lucky man who just left when he's talking. Come on, a soft voice. A voice so melodious. A voice that tickles the very skin of Marshall to the ears.
We are still slaves, and no one else will outlive me.
You mean I'm my son?
Yes, I'm my son.
Too much or too little in a meal.
Yes, that's all, my mistress.
Nothing.
You're very quiet today. Is anything the matter?
Sadness. I am completely exhausted. Today's training in the forest was really strenuous.
All the same, you went through with distinction, I'm told. From the reports I've been receiving, it's evident that you're doing very fine.
Well, I am doing my best.
You can now play the Kung Fu drum and dance the royal dances too.
It is so danceable.
The reports also indicate that you're doing very well in your lessons in battle strategy.
Father, this is time for you. Can't you discuss these things with him later? Allow him to eat.
All right, my ongoing princess. Let's eat.
Also, you don't seem to be eating your food. Don't you like it?
The training has taken away my appetite. Moreover, I'm not feeling too well. May I be excused to go and rest?
It is granted. You may go and rest. We shall meet tomorrow to not talk about the next stage of the physical endurance exercise.
Thank you, Dasibu. out of that chair.
Is there anything else I can do for you, my lord?
It's all right. You may go. I shall call you when I leave.
Thank you, my lord.
And if I guess, what will you give me?
Heart. All of it. Every piece of it.
You are? And I left you for?
No.
Come here, boy.
Oh, no. Just listen to my voice.
If you are not the same for me, then you must become a
girl. True, boy. I am a girl.
Oh, I see. Of course, I knew it was you alone.
I pretended you couldn't make out who.
Well, you shocked me. Too bad for you, then. I've asked you to leave me alone.
And I have tried to stay away from your charming eyes for 7 full market days without success. And I have decided to come back to you and appeal to you again.
Appeal to who?
Smile you have. Smile like sunshine after a heavy downpour. Let's burst out a million fingers to feel the living and I'm living alive. Sharp little fingers that can be warmth, real warmth that can resist the wetness of the air. And put life, real life, sweet, sweet life that warms the blood. Just listen carefully. Come to me quickly. Trust me and strengthen me through the veins. Will you feel a sweet, sick, shock, sickening at the very core of the heart? A sensation that is sweeter than any moon has ever tasted.
Incredible.
Like I want you.
And you, if I may ask, is this beloved showing you wish to share yours?
Need you ask? You are that fortunate man, my love.
Look, Echa, I prefer to be my set of misfortune.
Oh, why? Am I not fit to be the mother of your children? Everybody in this palace agrees that you and I are made for each other.
Well, I don't think like everybody else. I think like myself. I please myself. And perhaps my mother.
But my father also thinks we'll be a very good pair.
So he said to you, too. True.
What at all? Am I not a woman? Don't I know what is good for me? Don't I know which man I want to share my bed with?
Very much. I'm really fond of you as a...
Oh, I'm not dog or cat. your love, your heart, all of it. And now keep your mind, all of it. Let us go a little bit beyond fondness and fondling. Let's share our love together. And when death comes, we shall share that together too.
You're not going to ask.
What do you mean?
It is ever and ever, forever and ever impossible.
Oh. Impossible? How?
Look, Echa, I explained everything to you 7 months ago. Didn't I? I asked you to leave me alone and find yourself a new man.
The truth of its things every day. So would it be impossible for me to forget you, my love?
But I think you try. You try to forget about me, to jump me out of your memory. You made promises.
Yes, I said all that. Indeed, I promised. But after 7 market days, I feel.
Hey! Stop making me angry. You feel what?
That has never been my intention. I wish Come in, my father.
My lord, the husband has asked me to bring you.
For what?
My lord, it is time for an assistant. Everyone in the palace is seated, except for you. So I am sent here to bring you.
And is my cousin a shared sitter?
No, my lord. However, one of her guardmen is much to escort him.
All right. May we go?
Yes, my lord. Yes, sir.
The men must bring along their hoes, cutlasses, and axes. The women must bring their brooms. Nobody is to come there empty-handed. Anybody who fails to do so will be dealt with according to the custom. I repeat, anybody who fails to do so will be dealt with according to the custom. I am done.
Oh, it's significant for us to bring this out and then share. Hey, you want me to talk to you? I'm talking to you. My room is the
Okay, enough. I will tell you. But my first promise not to tell anybody. Hey! What did you take me for? Am I not a fellow slave like you? And do I not remember what our forefathers said? That under no circumstance should a slave be treated as a fellow slave. Well, if you doubt my loyalty.
Enough, enough, enough!
Oh! I will tell you, I'm trying. Oh. But first, see if somebody's coming. Yes, but you must remember that Musa is a kingdom where was said by time. Women go into giant trees with their roots deeply in the fertile soil.
I would doubt that.
Akosia, there's one thing I have to ask.
Remember,
I'm trying to remember. And you told me this market is this alone.
Listening. And that's all it is. What is it?
We have observed a change
hear you correctly? Did you just say my daughter has changed color?
A bit, yes. She has changed color a bit.
Hold it there. She has changed color. She has changed color. She hasn't changed. She hasn't changed. Who ever heard of someone being a little bit pregnant? If you are pregnant, you are pregnant. If you are not, you are not. Which are you saying?
The whole thing.
That's the bird. You've heard them. How do you know?
Oh, but you know we are women.
Who is this? We are women. Resort. That's the way I answered the question. Expected a more sensible answer than that. Perhaps. You've forgotten the penalty. That's a waste of sleep. That's not less a person of royal blood.
Hey, no, shall we please? And then we are very much aware of the penalty.
Fine. Now to my question. How do you know?
As for me, I was sitting by somewhere when I was able to tell you.
And Akosia, how did you do?
Oh, that's great. I heard this from Yadrando. But, that's great. If you take a closer look at our position's teeth, you see that they're not very swollen. And I used to have said, what is a bit?
You amuse me indeed. Don't you think our princess is only putting on a bit of weight?
From the feet upwards.
So that is why you think she's pregnant then?
Oh, that's the thing. How about that? About 2 days ago, I took a closer look at her mistress' palms when she was asleep. And I realized that they are turning very pale.
Her face stands out most of the time.
And ready to shout at anybody at the least provocation.
There's too much blood in her system. That's all.
I think you're right, that's right. There's too much blood.
She wasn't very busy and was sluggish and asleep most of the time.
That's a fever. Yes, a fever. Let's get into the new chair and
boil. Hey, what about her eyes?
What about them?
They have become sleepy.
You mean the cheekbones more pronounced?
Ochami, what do you say to that?
Couldn't be journalist.
Journalist or fever.
How are you two so sure that you cannot be journalist or fever?
Are you herbalists?
No, we are not herbalists. But we believe that if it were to be fever, there will be a resultant loss in appetites.
But here is the case where she wants to eat a lot of delicacies and insatiable appetite for white cream.
Let's think about indiscriminately.
So you are sure it's pregnancy?
Yes, we are.
And not fever?
No.
Or jaundice?
Never.
Or any other pair of moments?
Yes, we are sure it is pregnancy.
That's the word. Those were the clear tones and the sound of conviction issuing from the mouth of the two servants, Aja and Akosia.
Very well. I shall summon your mistress into our presence here and find out the truth for myself.
This is nice.
Hey, wait, wait for Charlie, please, I beg. I was going to talk to you first. Yes, Charlie, we are here. Listen for her, my lord.
Charlie, go to the woman's quarters and ask your papi to allow the chair into my presence.
Yes, my lord.
And come with it.
Yes, my lord.
This is interesting. That a girl of royal blood should get pregnant out of wedlock. I don't believe it. I simply don't want to bring myself to believe it. It is an abomination that the gods would not condone. And to think that it is my daughter, princess of the Ebusa kingdom, who should do such a thing. I shudder to think that of it. Amaitia will never drag the name and sanctity of the school into such disrepute.
Father, I understand it's you who called for me.
That is true, my daughter. Sit down there. Ochami,
You and the woman must excuse us for a brief moment. I shall call you when I need you.
Women, listen. My daughter, you look a little bit sick.
I haven't been feeling well of late. That's all. I just had a little fever. That's all. Anyway, I am getting better.
Are you sure it's just fever?
What sort of question is that? Am I not old enough to know what ails me?
Please, please. Let's wear our minds over our tempers. Between father and child, tempers should not be let loose. But when that happens, it's like pulling the hair on one's skin. It is you who feels the pain.
I don't think you disturbed my sleep to tell me about the rising and falling of tempers.
No, I'm coming to the main subject presently. My daughter, rumors have it that the piece of fertile land I hold out to you on the valley of those two hills on the border of Ayase has been cultivated by some unknown farmer, and the crops are almost ready for harvesting. Wipe your tears, my daughter. I've already done all that.
Oh, thank you, Father.
However, my soldiers seem to think that you are the right person to tell us who cultivated the land.
Nonsense! What sort of soldiers are they? How do I know the culprits? Father, if I knew the offender, you'd be the first I'll come to with his name. I swear to that.
What I don't seem to understand is how a woman's land can be cultivated without him knowing the farmer.
Father, I haven't ceded the land to anybody. I swear by...
Don't swear yet. Give me your hands. Show me your palms. Spread them into mine. Look me straight in the face. Well, I don't blame you for not understanding metaphorical language. All this talk about crop harvesting and land cultivation is simply that you are pregnant. Don't look down. Look me in the eyes and deny it, my daughter. Say it is not true.
So you trapped me.
Is it true then that you are what the woman say you are? Don't go yet. One more question. Who is the man responsible? Will you stop staring at me that way and answer the question?
If you were not my father, I would have spat at your face.
And I shall have you tortured for the rest of your life. What nonsense! Whoever went looking for a walking stick and picked one that grew taller than himself. Foolish! This is the power that ever be taller than the Calabash of the people. You draw that statement at once. I said you draw before I call in the dance. Stop!
Stop! I'm a
now you're going to tell me who made you pregnant. I'm waiting. Won't you speak? You know the penalty that awaits a person of royal blood who gets pregnant before she's properly married. It is an abomination. Exile is you, I'm talking.
Will you take your hands off me? I'm not going to tell you anything. You can be your worst.
Come back here. Stop. I said come back. She's gone.
Yeah, yeah.
Call those two women in here.
That's where I've heard of women.
Woman, I'm sad to see that your allegations have been proved. Right. Pregnant. However, she will not disclose the man responsible. But leave that aspect to me. I shall find out in my own way. Ochami,
Nana,
let it be the women that I thank them for coming straight to you with their observations. Such are the people who will not stay to see the kingdom fall apart. I wish them peace. At the right time, they shall be rewarded abundantly. They may go.
Women, so says the Asuprem, that your kindness shall never be forgotten. You may go on with peace. Your heads belong to your shoes.
Thank you, old king.
Tommy,
Nana,
I wish to be alone for a moment.
I understand.
Thank you.
prophet now arrived, the mighty one, whose mighty wings spread over all the kingdom, arise in pomp and majesty. Let the drums rumble.
Serious matter affecting the kingdom of Yahusha. Honorable chiefs and elders, so says Dasubre, that since two heads have always proved better than one, he is no fool to attempt to carry all the bunch of food on his head when he can tie two bundles for his wife to carry one, thereby making his own lighter.
God forbid that Dasubre should be a fool.
All right. Some of you already know the reason for which I call this Deba. Nonetheless, I shall not hesitate to restate it.
So says Gaspar, that since we do not only wish to know the unknown, but at times wish to know that which we already know, and in doing so makes us double sure of that which we already know, he, Gaspar, shall repeat to both the fed and unfed ears the purpose of this Deba.
Let my wayward daughter come forward.
Hey, Dad, bring the wayward daughter at once.
She who stands there before us is a product of my knowledge, a daughter of royal blood, Amenta is her name. She harbors in that protruding flesh a seed secretly and wrongfully sown out of unacceptable wedlock.
Hey,
Oh yes! Is it not a shameful thing for a Christian to do? Have a good mind to start.
Thank you. That's
well, I shall not sit in judgment, lest I do it in partiality. Therefore, I ask, or whosoever man, heir apparent, to pronounce judgment, take the sword of office.
As a matter of fact, this is most unexpected. Honestly, I shall proceed to the solemn duty that's devolved upon me.
Not there, that's right. Not there. It is unlawful to pronounce judgments upon any of the students, except the great judgment student.
Yes. But that is not for me.
It is so, my nephew. You ought to rest your buttocks on the great judgment student at least 3 times. Before any pronouncement you make can be binding, it is custom.
I can't. It is really. All right. I shall do as the custom says. Condemn you to death.
Oh.
No. No. I refuse to think of it. The thought of it revolts my mind. I'll be told, in no uncertain terms, that long before my grandfather's, great grandfather's mother was born, the customs were there. All the same, my cousin. Be bold and tell us who did this foul deed. I decree that he who saw this unwanted seed in royal stores shall not live to see the dawn of day after his apprehension. Should he be hiding in the clouds, we shall pluck him out like a fruit. And when he is brought to face the punishment of his crime, he shall not be given a hearing. The genitals with which he saw the unwanted seed in royal soil shall be severed from the rest of his body and presented in an apartment before all the elders, chiefs, and people of Ebusa. If he's uncircumcised, both the parents shall die. Wow.
Well spoken, my nephew.
Well, my cousin, may the gods of our elders, and may the gods of our elders grant me no respite if the culprit is found and duly punished. And if I fail to fulfill my words, may the people of Ebusa take my life. Name the father of the unborn child, and you may go free. Ochane, let my cousin know that we are listening.
Beautiful princess, the elders and the people are all ears.
And faithful cousin of mine,
thank you.
Do you this day ask me to tell the world whose fruit I bear in this paltry flesh? You ask me to tell you, don't you know?
Hey.
Have you so soon forgotten the night we shared together in my chamber?
He must die.
Right.
all right. If you insist that you must die according to the customs, then I do not have much to say. Executioner! Take this nephew of mine to the outskirts of the devil and bring us his genitals. Collect an alcohol from the woman's quarters on which he placed the seven genitals. We are waiting for you. Go!
But take note, all that which happened notwithstanding, I really do love you. I admire your free spirit and godliness, which, in my case, was knocked away by my mother's ambition and the male mask.
I cannot let you go.
Thank you.
Executioner!
Dasibe!
Take them away!
Dasibe! Oh, Dasibe!
Oh, what the deal? Ah!
Oh,
calamity. Why have you descended upon me in Corinth? Lying breathless in the woman's quarters is a one-time symbol of the kingdom's living courage. Oh, yeah, Kretri. Yeah, so what, Kretri? My lovely sister, take away from me this colorful but deceitful shelter, and let the skies see and hear me groan. Let the spirit of the departed see my tears freely flow.
Thank you.